Good day, student. My name is Ambari Rasakola Banji. I will be your physics teacher for today's lesson. Topic, alternating current 2. Objective, at the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to analyze the concept of alternating current in a simple circuit with emphasis on 1. Determining the current in the circuit, A. In resistors and inductors, and B. Resistance, inductors, and capacitors. And 2. Solving quantitative problem on power in AC circuit. And 3. Solving numerical problem in AC circuit. LR circuit only. Consider the diagram above, where we have the voltage and then inductor. We have the voltage across L, which is the inductor, and we have the voltage across R, which is the voltage across resistor. Also below it, we have waveform diagram where we have VL leading VR. Using the phasor diagram where we have VL leading VR by angle 90, and going through the equation, we have E square is equal to VR square plus VL square. Expanding the equation, it gives us E is equal to I root all over root into bracket R square plus XL square. If you expand the equation further, current will give us E over Z, where Z is equal to root of bracket R square plus XL square, where Z is equal to impedance of the circuit. The angle between the resultant EMF and the current is tan theta, where tan theta is equal to VL over VR, and which is equal to sigma L over R. Theta, therefore, is equal to arctan sigma L over R. RCL circuit only. Consider the diagram shown above, where we have the inductor, the capacitor, and the resistor, and the voltage across each of them is also shown. The phasor diagram is given by where we have VC pointing down, VL moving up, and also we have a VR at perpendicular angle to the two of them. Using Pythagoras theorem, we have E square is equal to VR square plus bracket open VL minus VC bracket close square. Expanding the equation, we have IR square, which represents VR, plus bracket open I sigma L minus I sigma C bracket closes square. Expanding the equation for that, E will now becomes IZ, where Z is equal to impedance. The impedance is given by root of bracket open R square plus bracket open sigma L minus sigma C bracket closes square. The phase angle between the main voltage and the current is obtained from tan theta is equal to VL minus VR bracket closes all over VR, which is equal to bracket open sigma L minus sigma C bracket close all over R. We'll be going on break. After the break, we shall continue. Thank you. Welcome back. Power in AC. Power in AC is quite different from power in DC because power in direct current DC does not involve any non-inductive element, that is capacitor or inductor. The voltage and current are in phase and there is no phase differences. Thus, PAC is equal to IV. I repeat, thus PDC is equal to IV. However, in AC cycled. I is equal to I naught sine omega t, and V is equal to V naught sine omega t, which implies that power is equal to IV, which is equal to I sine omega t multiplied by V naught sine omega t. Hence, I naught V naught sine square omega t. But sine square omega t is equal to half. Therefore, power, which is equal to IV, is equal to I naught V naught all over 2. Also, if power is resolved into its component, that is, along the x-axis and y-axis, the components of power along the horizontal constitute the true or real power. Therefore, power is equal to P is equal to IV cos theta. That is, P is equal to IV cos theta. Cos theta is otherwise known as power factor. I repeat, cos theta is otherwise known as power factor. The component along the vertical, that is the reactive power, is zero because the power absorbed is zero. That is, Q is equal to IV sine theta. I repeat, Q is equal to IV sine theta. The resultant of the two is the apparent power of the cycle. Thus, cos theta is equal to R over Z. I repeat, cos theta is equal to R over Z, which implies that cos theta is equal to resistance over impedance. Electrical resonance. From the earlier subtopic above, it has been indicated that a capacitor causes the current to lead the voltage by 90 degree CCS series circuit, and that an inductor causes the current to lag behind the voltage by 90 degree CLR circuits. From the above, it is possible to adjust the value of the capacitance and inductance in an LCR cycle so that their effect neutralize each other, that is, sigma C is equal to sigma L. When this is done, the resistor then becomes the only factors that limit the current, which is maximum. The value of frequency at which the effect of the capacitor and the inductor are neutralized so that the current value becomes maximum is known as resonance frequency, F naught. It is derived from the relation sigma C is equal to sigma L, and which is equal to 1 all over 2 pi F C is equal to 2 pi F L. Thus, F square is equal to 1 all over 4 pi square L C. And then if you rearrange properly, F naught, which is equal to resonant frequency, will be equal to 1 all over 2 pi root LC. Hence, at the resonance frequency F naught, the circuit is said to be in a state of resonance. The variation of current with the frequency showing resonance is illustrated in the diagram below. Thank you very much. We'll be going on break. After the break, we will come back to solve work example. Welcome back. Work the sample. Question 1. 220 volt 60 hertz AC supply is connected across an arrangement of a coil of 3 Henry and 60 ohms resistor in series with 400 ohms resistor. Determine the current flowing in the coil. Solution. Using the formula, I is equal to V all over root into bracket R square plus sigma L square, where I is equal to current in amps, V applied voltage, and square root R square plus sigma L square is equal to circuit impedance. But sigma L square is equal to 2 pi FL square is given by 2 times 3.142 times 60 times 3 all square which give us 1131.12 square ohms. Total resistance will now be 60 plus 400, which is equal to 460 ohms. Hence, I will be V all over square root into bracket R square plus sigma L square. Put all the value inside, you will now get a current to be 220 all over 122.1, which will give us 1.8016 times 10 raised to negative 1 ampere. Example 2. Compute the impedance of a series arrangement of 1.5 Henry inductor, 0.4 microfarad capacitor, and 500 ohms resistor when the frequency is 300 cycles per second. Draw the vector impedance diagram. Solution. Impedance Z is equal to square root of R square plus bracket sigma L minus sigma C bracket square, where R is equal to 500 ohms and sigma L is equal to 2 pi FL, which is equal to 2 times 3.142 times 300 times 1.5, giving us 2827.8 ohms. Sigma C is equal to 1 all over 2 pi FC, which will give us 1 all over bracket open 2 times 3.142 times 300 times 0.4 times 10 raised to negative 6. This is equal to 1326.1 ohms. Z therefore becomes, if you substitute all the value inside, Z will become 1582.8 ohms. B, vector impedance diagram. Consider the diagram shown above, where we have V, R is equal to 500, and you have sigma 1546.7. And you are asked to calculate the impedance. The impedance will be the resultance of the two vectors. That's where you have, where you now have sigma, your sigma C is pointing down 1326.1. If you analyze it properly, if we give you the impedance, if you give you Z value as calculated above. Thank you. Assignment. 1. A 120 volt, 60 hours main supply is connected with an iron coil of 3 Henry and 60 ohms. The coil is placed in series with a resistance of 380 ohms. What is the current flowing in the entire circuit? The answer is 98.2 milliampere. Question 2. In an LCR circuit involving AC, power is absorbed only in 1. A. Capacitor. B. Resistor. C. Inductor. D. Resistor and capacitor. The answer is B. Thank you. Till we meet next week. God bless you all.